All right, are we ready? Let's call the meeting to order at 7:00.
Roll call.
Let's start. Melissa?
Here.
Jill?
Here.
Lloyd?
Here.
Ben?
Here.
Along with Maggie, Andy, Justin, and Sean. Oh, and Joel.
Hi.
Pledge allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Does anybody have any open forums? I need to add to the agenda under item B, Personnel Committee, item 4, Attorney RFP. Is there a motion to approve the agenda?
I'll make a motion to approve the agenda with the amendment.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Sorry.
Aye.
Okay. Sorry. Approval of the consent agenda. Is there any discussion? I'll make a motion to approve the consent agenda.
I will second the motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
Is there any opposed? Motion passes 5-0. Sheriff's Department.
Yep, back here. Yeah, nothing to do out of the ordinary. Doing as usual.
Thank you. Meetings? Melissa?
Let's see. We have...
Looks like the volunteer meeting, and we had our Beyond the Yellow Ribbon meeting. We had the workshop, and then council meeting.
I attended, there was some union meetings that occurred, a couple meetings at the city hall, a couple workshop chops, the park and rec meeting, the personnel meeting, and then the EDA meeting just before this meeting.
I attended Personnel Committee, Park and Rec, Union, met with Rose Haven in regards to the fire, Community Action for the city and purpose of the fire, volunteer meeting, and the newly elected in conference.
Council meetings, WCAP meetings, workshops, and special meetings we had.
Attended the council meeting, fire department meeting, the special meetings that we had, EDA that was right before here. That's what I have.
Kevin is not here.
He's at Woodland Township. This is amazing.
Oh. All right. Brew.
Union Mayor and Council. You should have in your packet the draft of our minutes from our last meeting, to which I would like to draw your attention to the egg hunt. I just want to remind you that that is coming up on April 15th. And remind anyone who might happen to see or hear this that we will still take donations of plastic bags and baskets. I did have somebody drop off two great big bags to me today, so that's great. Our charitable organization of the year, I want to remind you that because we've changed the dates, it will not be a special honoree this year. We will just be honoring everyone. And things are underway with that as well. There is some new, great, exciting things going on at Regional Park, which Justin and Sean will address tonight. I also wanted to let you know, you guys at last meeting approved lanyards, which Sean was kind enough to create, and this is what they look like. If you would like to see it closer, you certainly may, but this is it with the new logo. I think that is it as far as city stuff goes. We do have one announcement that is non-city related, and that is a fundraiser for Rose Haven. And you'll see flyers like this around town. Media has been contacted, etc. It will be here on Saturday, April 8th from 4 to 7 if anyone is interested. We'll also take donations for Rose Haven at that time as well. So, any questions for me? Thank you.
Megan, finance.
We have to develop the DNR grant under project.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, so Mayor and Council, as part of the regional park shelter / warming house grant application that Justin and I have been working on. At the previous council meeting, you approved that staff go ahead and apply for this grant. Staff did complete a preliminary application. We sent it in to the DNR for review, and they did provide a couple of items for feedback that we could improve that would make our application stronger. When we do submit it by on March 31st, we do need a resolution of support from the council that's in front of you today.
Is there any discussion on this? Is there a motion to approve the resolution?
I'll make a motion approving resolution 2017-05, the DNR grant application.
I'll second that.
Melissa?
Aye.
Jill?
Aye.
I'll vote aye. Wade?
Aye.
Ben?
Aye.
Motion passes 5-0.
Mayor, I can do the developer escrow.
Oh, no.
I don't know if you know, but at the time when developers do the developers agreements in the city, when we have new developments in the city, we always collect an escrow, which covered our legal expenses, our engineering expenses, planning expenses, anything like that. It's what it costs us to record everything. We have a couple developments, I believe there's three of them, that go back to 2004, 5, and 6, I think it is, that were started in town and they never went any further and they are bankrupt. They're not even around anymore. So I've attached a resolution. This is just kind of some housekeeping. The money is sitting out there in the escrow. We have nobody to give it back to. So we will put it into our general fund. So there's a resolution attached, number 2017-04. Allowing us to transfer the funds from the developer escrows to the general fund to clear up those funds.
Is there any discussion? Is there a motion?
I'll make a motion to approve resolution 2017-04, a resolution allowing for the transfer of funds from the developer escrow fund to the general fund. I'll second that.
Sorry about that.
Ben?
Aye.
Boyd?
Aye.
I'll vote aye. Jill?
Aye.
Melissa?
Aye.
Motion passes 5-0.
Sean, come over.
Good evening, Mayor and Council. The first item on my list tonight is we're seeking a resolution to adopt the five-year capital improvement plan. As we all know, this has been a quite lengthy process. It was identified back in 2015 by a planning session with staff and the council. We have gone through the steps required to develop and make the plan a realization. As we've discussed in a couple of workshops, this is no means written in stone. It's a living document that can evolve as we see fit. In addition to that, it encompasses the entire city as far as fire, parks, streets, utilities, the whole gamut. So if there is any questions, I would like to seek a motion for Resolution 2017-08, adopting the capital improvement plan.
Is there any discussion on it? I think we've all discussed it pretty lengthy. Is there a motion?
I'll make a motion approving the resolution of number 2017-08, resolution establishing priorities for projects within a five-year capital improvement plan.
I will second that.
Jill?
Aye.
I'll vote aye. Boyd?
Aye.
Ben?
Aye.
Melissa?
Aye.
Motion passes 5-0.
Thank you. The next item on my list is franchise fees. As we were working on this capital improvement plan and kind of exploring some different avenues for revenue, we came across this franchise fee opportunity. What a franchise fee is where the city has the authority to address a fee to private utility bills for certain projects that the city wants to see accomplished. We haven't dug into it a whole lot. We spoke about it at our last workshop regarding the capital improvement plan, and I'm seeking a motion from the council to have staff dive into this further to get more information. I didn't want to spend a whole lot of time. This is not where the council wants to go, so. So I'm seeking a motion and authority to move forward with that.
Is there any discussion on this? Hello? A motion to move forward?
Can we ask a question at any time?
Sure, go ahead.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, come on up.
I was just wondering, since this will be passed along to us through the utility bill, is that going to be considered in any way for the council?
Mm-hmm.
So.
It was discussed at the last meeting to, they're just moving forward to see right now, like what fees, what it takes to go ahead and do this, and then there will be a, there is a public hearing to have residents come in and discuss it as well.
Okay.
Yep. Any other discussion? Questions? Is there a motion to have staff look into this a little more?
I will make a motion for staff to review farther the franchise fees.
Is there a second?
I'll second that.
Boyd?
Aye.
Ben?
Aye.
Melissa?
Aye.
Jill?
Aye.
I'll vote aye.
Motion passes 5-0.
Thank you, Council. The next item on our list is, it is that time of year again to start looking for seasonal help. for all the different summer projects that are coming down the line. Last year, we hired 3 seasonal employees, and we are seeking the same for 2017. I need a motion for approval on that too, please.
I will make a motion to approve the seasonal hiring of 3 employees for 2017.
I'll second that.
Melissa?
Aye.
Jill? How about aye? Lloyd?
Aye.
Ben?
Aye.
Motion passes. Thank you.
Okay, the last thing on our list, Mayor Council, is we had a vacancy, in the Public Works / Administration Assistant position. We advertised for filling that position. We had 69 applications received for filling that position. We reviewed that, those 69 applications. It came down to 5. Personnel committee and staff reviewed those 5 finalists, and we interviewed that. The staff also met with the personnel committee after the interviews, and it was concluded and recommended that place a conditional offer of employment to Jessica Bonwell, very well qualified local resident, and to fill that position. And after council approval, we'll make it official.
I do have one question. She is all aware of union.
Yes.
And her start date would be like April 3rd, is that correct?
Yes, I discussed with her when we made the conditional offer that she would like to start on April 3rd.
Does she have any experience on this job?
She has accounting degrees and a lot of customer service experience. Not so much on the utility billing end, but she's certainly very easy to be trained into that. Very good customer service attitude.
So we discussed this quite a bit at personnel, and it was decided kind of that we felt it was more important that they be very customer service oriented. You can train on computer modules and how to run a computer. You can't train on customer service and being friendly to the public. And so we found that more important than specific background related to the utility billing side of things, which is one of the reasons she stood up, is because she had what I was told.
Yeah, but did we do a background check? Or was it
background checks are not done until after they're hired.
What's that?
Background checks aren't done until after the council approves it, and then we go through the background checks and stuff.
So then if something were to come up, they would come back to us and let us know before?
Yeah.
Okay. It's not related to anybody on the fire department or anything connected with the city.
She lives in the city, so correct.
She does not live in the city, but it is right next to it.
Oh.
Where does she live?
Next to the city limits, I guess.
She has a Montrose address.
Montrose, but yeah.
She does have a Montrose address, correct.
That's good. That's good. Any other questions or comments? Motion?
I'll make a motion to approve the hiring of Jessica Bonwell for the Public Works / Administrative Assistant position.
Thank you.
Justin.
Good evening, Mayor and Council. Three items on the agenda for you this evening. First one is a grant opportunity for the Trunk Highway 25 project to sell the town. I've spoken about this project. Maybe I'll take items one and three sort of together here and explain the project a little more. MnDOT currently has plans to resurface Highway 25 from Montrose down to Watertown in the year 2018. And we've been speaking with MnDOT on that item to try to work with MnDOT on a way to get a trail installed with that project from where the sidewalk currently ends, just south of Highway 12 down to the Rock Hill development. And basically through a lot of discussion with MnDOT, MnDOT has agreed to pull the project, pull that section of the project out of their project. They don't wanna basically mess their project up or add any more difficulty to their project, since it's just a simple mill and overlay project. They don't want to add trail construction, right-of-way acquisition. There's also some water and sewer work that needs to be done there. So they don't want to add all that stuff into their project. So they've agreed to pull that segment out of the project. They would still fund everything that they normally would fund. So they would fund the resurfacing of the highway. Additionally, they would fund storm sewer improvements, curb and gutter, and widening of the highway on the west side of the road in order to fit the trail. And those are improvements that would need to be done for the benefit to both the highway as well as a benefit to basically getting that trail installed there. So we have a letter included in your packet from MnDOT that they have written up and indicated that they're willing to fund these improvements. The city would be responsible for the costs of the right-of-way acquisition, the trail construction, and then any city utility replacement costs. So to help try to fund this project, the city's portion of the cost, there's a grant available through the DNR, competitive grant opportunity. It's called the Local Trail Connections Grant, and it's geared towards promoting relatively short trail connections to where people live in desirable locations. So I think this project and the intent of this project really fits in with the grant. The maximum grant amount is $150,000. There's $300,000 worth of eligible costs in the project for that. So it would be capped at $150,000. It's not a lot of money in the grant program. There's only $800,000 total to be divided up amongst three different park and trail grant programs. So, it's a pretty very competitive process, but I think it's definitely worth applying. So first item of action would be to, if you're in support of applying for that, would be to pass a resolution. That same thing for the park shelter has to be submitted with the grant application. And the deadline is March 31st. So that was resolution 2017-10.
Now, do you say the highway department's going to do their work on what, 2019?
Actually, 2018 is their surfacing project. They have indicated that funding for the additional funding that they're willing to provide to the city for that portion would be available in 2019. So it would be our goal to, which actually starts June or July 1st of 2018. Their fiscal year starts July 1st of 2018. Okay. So we'd have constructed either in late 2018 or early 2019.
So if we apply for that grant, we can wait until after they get done with their portion before we do ours?
It'd be two separate projects completely, so they would still do their surfacing in 2018, and then ours would either be, depending on how quickly right-of-way acquisition goes and the plan approval process with MnDOT, we would either gear that towards late 2018 construction or spring of 2019 construction.
Yeah, because it wouldn't be feasible to do that before the highway does their share.
Right, we would do the highway project, the highway stuff, the stuff that MnDOT would be paying for, we would do that as part of the trail project, actually. But MnDOT would reimburse us for the cost of that.
Yeah.
Yep.
But I mean, if MnDOT goes in there and does what they're gonna do, then we just top off, cost us less money, right? But if we were to go in there and do that before the highway finishes their part, it'd be a lot of cost.
Oh, right, exactly. Yes, it's definitely most cost efficient to do it at the same time.
We're doing it in conjunction with them.
Yep, that's the most cost effective.
Any other discussion?
I've got a question.
Yep.
If there is no grant money coming from the state, then there won't be the trail project, it'd just be a road improvement?
I wouldn't necessarily say that's the case. There's, in the capital improvement plan, this project is identified, and there is a funding source identified to fund this project without the grant.
What would that be?
That was
cash reserves.
Cash on hand.
The utility funds in general.
Any other questions? Is there a motion?
Make a motion approving resolution 2017-10 for the grant application from the Minnesota Department of Natural Resources for local trail connection programs.
I'll second that motion.
Ben?
Aye.
Lloyd?
Aye.
All vote aye. Jill?
Aye.
Melissa?
Aye.
Motion passes 5-0.
So then I'll jump over the Garfield Avenue project to jump to item number 3 on there. Then the next thing would be if council wanted to proceed with the project, we would ask you to authorize us to prepare the plans and specifications, proceed with right-of-way acquisition and easements as needed for the project, and also work with MnDOT in a cooperative agreement, draft cooperative agreement, which outlines the detailed roles and responsibilities between the city and MnDOT, both for cost sharing and during construction and then after construction for maintenance of the trail, storm sewer system, and things of that nature. And then the cooperative agreement would come back to you for final approval prior to the project being constructed. What else? There's about 700 feet of water main and 800 feet of sanitary sewer that date back to the 1960s that would be included with the project. And then at the grant, our goal would be that, I guess if you wanted to proceed, we would probably hold off on right-of-way acquisition until we hear on the grant, because we would want to wait for special procedures that we need to follow if we get the grant money. So we would just, those grants should be announced, I believe, in late, early summer. Start meeting with MnDOT and defining some detailed design. Now, if we want to do this in 2018, we need to get moving on our right away. It sounds like a long ways off, but a project like this, MnDOT has some really detailed design review processes in place. So it goes to the District 3 for several reviews, and then after they sign off on it, it goes to Central Office. St. Paul for more detailed reviews, so they take a long time.
We have a question out there.
Yeah, Justin, is that going to include the drainage in front of the homeowners and all that stuff down Garfield, all down that way and everything?
Not this project, no. That's a different project.
Because I'm saying if it would include some of the homeowners and stuff, I think all the homeowners should be notified. You should have a meeting and tell them what's going on. To let them know.
Yeah, the Garfield Avenue project is item 2. We'll talk about that next year.
Any other discussion? Is there a motion to proceed with the plans?
I will make a motion to authorize Justin and city staff to proceed with the plans with specifications of the right-of-way acquisition and drafting cooperative agreements with MnDOT for the improvements on Trunk Highway 25 south of town.
I will second that.
Any
Jill?
Aye.
Melissa?
Aye.
Ben?
Aye.
Boyd?
I'm going to say no, because we wouldn't have to start this until we make sure we get the grant, right?
This is just a proceed to go ahead.
But even if we don't get the grant, it still kind of has to be done, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
Yeah.
It has to be done either way.
Right.
It's either this or wait another 50 years for MnDOT cost share.
You go yet?
Yeah.
I'll say yes. Motion passes five, so to proceed. Adjust and proceed.
All right, then we'll jump to item number two, the Garfield Avenue project. This project has also been identified in the capital improvement plan. It's currently identified for 2017 construction on the plan. Project scope identified in the CIP includes replacement of the bituminous surface of the roadway, keeping the existing roadway width the same, and not installing curb and gutter on the roadway. So essentially, the character of the street would not change other than replacing the surfacing, and then upgrading the street to make sure that it's compatible for commercial traffic on the south end of the project by the Dollar General store. And then it also would include drainage improvements in the ditch on the west side of the road, where there's currently a lot of drainage issues and water standing in that ditch. Basically, install a storm sewer system in the ditch, and then there's going to be a slight swale or a slight ditch that would remain in there for many months. So that's the scope of the project. The capital improvement plan is identified using cash on hand as the general fund for this project. And if you would like to proceed again, we would recommend that you authorize us to proceed with the plans and specs and preparing the bidding documents for the project.
Question.
Any questions?
Just for the record, this will be at no cost to them.
To the homeowners?
The property owners that are getting a benefit.
The capital, the way it's proposed, the capital improvement, that plan is correct.
It's up to the council to make that determination.
What's that?
It's up to the council to make that determination.
Oh, I understand. And good for them that it's not going to cost them any money, but just for the record, all of us on Buffalo Avenue, years ago, they got zero, absolutely zero benefit, got assessed thousands of dollars. And I realize that's water under the dam, but that just goes to show that how hardly anything makes sense in our. There's a definite benefit here, and if they don't have to pay, that's great for them, but I'm just saying, treat everybody the same.
This will be coming out of their tax money that we collect.
Well, yeah, we
but there won't be no special.
The only, that whole Buffalo Avenue thing was a ploy for Empire Building, and the developers made out, and we were screwed.
Yeah, I know that was a bad deal.
Any other discussion?
I have a question for Justin, actually. Which way does that drain then, back to the pond or the other way?
Drains to the north of the pond.
Will that create an additional problem with that pond?
No, because it all drains there currently. I mean, minus it.
So it's not draining anywhere right now, so I'm just wondering once it moves, if it'll create a problem with that, and then that would have to be addressed.
No.
Any other discussion? You need a motion, right, Justin?
That is correct.
I'll make a motion then to approve the authorization to proceed with the plans for Garfield Avenue.
I'll second.
Ben?
Aye.
Melissa?
Aye.
Jill?
Aye.
I'll vote aye. Lloyd?
Aye.
Motion passes five zero. Should we move to personnel?
Yep, so personnel that on March 6th, on the agenda was discussion regarding the public works administrative assistant position. It was discussed there that we would do the hiring of Jessica Bono, that was for council. There was discussion on the performance review documentation. Quick discussion on the League of Minnesota Cities annual salary benefits survey review. Maybe has more information on that if anybody has any questions. Discussion regarding the attorney RFP, which we will discuss in number four of this area. The apps meeting 65 reviews the chain of command if management is out of the office and who public works employees would receive authorization from. And then the puzzle event, which I think we should discuss a little bit further now, and then ordinance enforcement. That was it. But back to the Chamber of Commerce puzzle event. Michelle, do you want to present that information?
It was just talked about at the Chamber of Commerce. They're doing a puzzle event, I think it's in May. But we don't, I mean, we don't necessarily have to do it with them either. Jill has actually done this before, but what it is, it's like a team building type deal. Yeah, you've done it.
Yeah, so my family is semi-obsessed with these rooms. So basically you go into a room and your goal is to find your way out within an hour via different locks and codes and just pass knowledge. And it's a good team building activity. If you don't work with your team, you're not going to get out in time, but you basically have an hour to attempt to get out of these rooms. Some rooms lead you to other rooms where you just have to solve these riddles, solve these clues. They're fun, they're good team building activities. I've done it, I won't even tell you the number of rooms that I've done, but I've done a lot of them, and they're fun. They're really good, they're entertaining, and it's relatively cheap for, I think, the communication you get out of it with the others that you're with. But it was discussed at, potentially doing it at the council level, and then maybe going as far as the employee level as well. Just to work on the relationships with one another. Puzzles rooms are located right in Buffalo, so it's not far. It's three different rooms that you can do there. We can pick and choose which one we want. Has anybody else on Council Lena or anybody? Oh, yes, you're right.
What did you think?
That's fine. Yeah. You didn't do the one in Buffalo, though, right?
Yeah. My thought was to do council and, well, full staff and council. And just kind of do a group thing and, you know, because just to that interaction between everybody and kind of get that flow there. So, do you have any thoughts on that?
Anybody? Would council be?
Would homes? Go ahead.
So, are you discussing the city paying for you guys to play games?
It wasn't my intention.
That was, no, we would do it ourselves.
Oh.
I mean, that was my thinking behind it, was pay our own way, but to build the relationship between council and staff.
Well, I was just going to say, if the city's going to pay for it, if I'm
going to pay for it,
then I'd kind of like to have a tape or a recording of it so I can see how you did.
Right.
Because I'd like to know if you could figure your way out of the box.
I don't think it's, I mean,
it's all videotaped. You can probably
it is, yes, yes. And we would come back with discussion.
I'm being facetious here because I really don't think I should be paying for you guys to go play games.
Right. So. No, I agree with you on that aspect, but our intent is just to build because we do have a new council member. He's not really, he's not really new, but we do, Maggie is also new. Just kind of build the relationship. What our intent is, and no, we would not ask for the taxpayers to pay that fee. So, does anybody do we want to consider looking into this or letting it go?
What would we do?
Well, that's what we would have to look into.
Yeah. And I'd be open to it.
What the dates are, of it, times, dates, and just kind of get a feel for everybody's. The only other thought that I had was, and they have multiple rooms, so you could do it in a way where it's kind of like council versus staff, where you would be going to two different rooms and see who can actually have you. But I know the Chamber of Commerce kind of has a day dedicated with this room. That's where the idea originally came from. Did not come from me. I did not suggest it. It was Chamber of Commerce.
It was the Chamber. And that the cost through the Chamber, I believe the event is in May, but it's $25 a person.
That's what it is.
And it's an hour. There, the time is, I remember the time is 7:45. I just don't remember the exact date, so. I can get that information. I'll pass it on to Maggie, and then she can forward it out to everybody else.
Okay. So number two in personnel is performance review.
Oh, sorry. And I wasn't there. That's why.
Maggie, help remind me why we separated this out.
Do we have an approval on this? So the performance review documentation is essentially just we were updating our review documentation that we do for staff. I went to the personnel committee several times, kind of what they want to see in employee reviews. There's a policy, a wage and administration policy, that kind of highlights how we're going to be performing employee reviews, kind of, and then the documentation that goes with it when the actual review is occurs. So it was suggested by the personnel committee that it is added to the personnel policy as an addendum. And so it is coming to the council to be approved as part of the personnel policy to have this additional addendum added and used in the future when we do employee reviews.
I think I wasn't at the last personnel meeting, but with this one is more for public works. Correct? Or
no,
in general?
No, it's general.
Okay. Does it pertain then to like management?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So the idea was that any items that don't pertain to public works would be kind of NA, put an NA in that category. So the number two was to approve the amendment to the personnel policy to include that documentation.
Is there a motion then to add this to the personnel policy?
I'll make a motion to add the performance review documentation to the personnel policy as an addendum.
I'll second that motion.
When will that take effect?
Right away. Is there any approval?
That's the review.
Yeah, yes.
Okay, Ben?
Yes.
Melissa?
Aye.
Jill?
Aye.
I'll vote aye. Motion passes 5-0. Meeting still
So do we need to repost that then?
No.
It wouldn't.
Because the time didn't change.
What was that? And we're doing reviews though.
No, post that meeting because there's only two of you on.
Okay.
That meeting doesn't get posted.
That's right, because it's now just a standing meeting in one time.
Okay. All right. Item four.
What else? I'll do that one.
Okay. It was also discussed at the personnel meeting, some items were brought up from staff to council in regards to the attorney, our attorney communication. And so it was discussed at personnel, which I was unable to attend that meeting, but moving forward, we had brought some issues up to our attorney months ago in regards to a few things that were going on within the city. And we weren't really getting any feedback. So we reached out again to get the information, and we did get the feedback, but it took a little bit longer than anticipated. So, and there's just been, like we would typically have to, you know, the attorney's supposed to be at our 2 o'clock Mondays before council meetings. That has been pretty inconsistent. Just communication in general has been pretty inconsistent, and so I know it was discussed at personnel, but I did discuss it again after, since I wasn't at the personnel meeting, with staff and council, couple council members, to continue or to proceed with an RFP for attorneys. Any other discussion?
Want me to second it?
There's no motion yet, there's just a discussion.
Well, you really so, there, I can't repeat.
So then I will make the motion to move forward to have Mandy proceed with an RFP for attorney.
City attorney.
For city attorney.
I'll second it.
Melissa?
No.
Jill?
No.
Ben?
I'm going to go with my experience with what I have had with Mr. Pratt, and I'm saying no.
Okay. Motion fails. 3, 2, 1, Lloyd.
I will
vote
for it.
Okay. Any old business?
Oh, it's planning commission.
Oh, sorry.
So in front of you is the February 15th, 2017 planning commission meeting minutes. If you have any questions, I'm available to answer them.
Mayor, members of the City Council and public, the Planning Commission began working on the update of the comprehensive plan back in July of last year. The last comprehensive plan was prepared in 2002 with updates in 2006, so the document is about 10 years old. Including your packet was a 4-page summary of the contents, and then you also had a book or binder of the entire comprehensive plan. This is a guide that looks at the growth and redevelopment of the city through the year 2040. It is intended to look at 12 different areas of the community, including its history and vision, physical profile and natural resources, the demographics and social profile, economics, parks and trails, transportation, utilities, housing, municipal and public facilities, land use, and implementation. The Planning Commission utilized public input through a survey which had 228 responses, a visioning session. We received input from the Park and Rec Commission, the EDA, city staff, and city engineer. Also provided the document to the adjacent townships, Wright County, Buffalo, and Ogermontrose School District, and had a public hearing last month on February 15th at the Planning Commission level. The Planning Commission has recommended unanimously the adoption of the comprehensive plan, and included with your packet was Resolution 2017-09 for your consideration, and I'm happy to answer any questions you might have.
Are there any questions for Joanne?
Michelle, can I just say something? As a commissioner for planning and zoning, Joanne was a great help to us. I mean, we spent a lot of hours and time, you know, away from our own meetings dealing with this, so she's been a great asset to us, and she agreed to stay to present tonight, and then she's done. So thank you for her for doing that and helping us. It's kind of a long process.
I will make a motion to approve Resolution Number 2017-09 and Resolution approving the 2017 Montrose Comprehensive Plan and compilation of policy statements, goals, standards, and maps driving the overall development and redevelopment of the municipality.
Second.
Ben.
Aye.
Lloyd.
Aye.
Jill.
Aye.
Melissa.
Aye.
And I vote aye. Motion passes 5-0.
Thank you. And I appreciate the opportunity to work with the city on this project and the previous projects over the years. So thank you.
Thank you. Election of officers?
Mayor and Council, just in front of you is just some information, updated information on the Planning Commission officers. As you know, Corey DeWitt, the previous chairperson, resigned in December 2016. Therefore, the chairperson, Chuck Smallwood, moved into the position. It's a two-year position, so Chuck will carry out the rest of this year. In March of last year, as you know, Catherine Nyberger was nominated as secretary. I'm just bringing an update because a new vice chairperson was elected in, and that is Sylvia Henry. Just bringing this back to the council to take action on, just because there was a new chairperson that was elected at the last planning commission meeting.
We have to approve a vote, don't we?
Oh yeah, I would say so, since Chuck moved into a new position.
Is there a motion to approve Chuck as the new chairperson for planning and zoning?
I will move to approve Chuck as the new chairperson for planning and zoning.
Lloyd?
Aye.
Ben?
Aye.
Jill?
Aye.
Melissa?
Aye.
I'll vote aye. Motion passes 5-0. Motion for Sylvia? I'll make the motion for Sylvia as the new vice chair.
Second.
Jill?
Aye.
Melissa?
Aye.
Ben?
Aye.
Lloyd?
Aye.
And I'll vote aye. Motion passes 5-0. There is no old business, so new business. So wastewater treatment facility annexation.
Thank you, Mayor and Council. I'll take this one. This is a frequent item, and as you know, the city has annexation agreements, orderly annexation agreements with the two townships, Woodland and Marysville. And we can take these, I'll just sort of summarize both resolutions and we can vote on them separately. we had an amendment that the state, we had an amendment that the state of Minnesota wanted the city to do for their annexation agreements based on a law change that said that the city should be paying the township the various fees for annexation instead of the individual seeking to be annexed into the city. That's not very clear from the statutory change because it allows for basically whatever agreement the city wants to make with the individual. So it's not obvious, but that was the interpretation of the administrative law judge at the state of Minnesota Municipal Boundary Adjustment Unit, who's a new judge as of last year. So we revised the annexation agreement that came before you, and I, on my way home one day, I personally delivered it down there because I just wanted to make sure they got it, and sometimes you don't hear anything. And they said, well, we want you to have a new resolution also approving that because they consider the resolution, and the resolution has a language in there about the city is the one paying the township instead of the individual. So that language, just for an example of that, is in your packet, page 110. There's, let's see, the last two whereases at the top of that page is really the only difference in what we've already seen. So they wanted that specific language in there, even though it's not clear that that needs to be in there. So I said, okay, fine, we'll do that, we'll have it signed. I can either get the resolutions from Meg or Meg, Send them in to the person at the state, but we can talk about that. So these two resolutions cover your two orderly annexation agreements, and it's fine to go to bed with everything that needs to be signed.
Any discussion on that? Is there a motion?
Make a motion approving resolution number 2017-06, a resolution approving the annexation of land in the city of Montrose pursuant to a revised orderly annexation agreement between the city of Montrose and the town of Woodland.
Is there a second?
I'll second that.
Boyd?
Aye.
Ben?
Aye.
Melissa?
Aye.
Jill?
Aye.
All vote aye. Motion passes. 5-0.
Michelle, I have a question.
Yes.
Do we have to redo the mock annexation that never went through?
No, this is just the sort of implementing resolution that amends the actual agreement between you and the township. It doesn't touch individual projects.
Okay. Oh, because this says wastewater treatment facility, that's why.
Oh, yeah. But yeah, I took an older model and just in the language they wanted. So
will we have to redo a resolution for that
no,
one since
no.
It had the old language?
No, because I just took verbatim. No, I just okay. I asked him that question because okay. We had two pending ones and I just took verbatim.
Perfect.
What do you want us to do?
Okay.
So, thank you for asking.
So what do we need to do on that?
So these resolutions need to go with the revised annexation agreement that we've already adopted. So I have that agreement, so we'll just need to get these resolutions.
More specifically, the mock property.
That's going to be done as far as I was told that it's the state that's going to be done as long as we get these things signed in. Because that's been approved by the council.
So is there going to be confirmation that is taken care of? So that we don't have to change this?
Absolutely.
Okay. Thank you. So then we need a motion then for resolution 2017-07. I'll make the motion to approve resolution 2017-07. Is there a second?
Second.
Jill?
Aye.
Melissa?
Aye.
Lloyd?
Aye.
Ben?
Aye.
Upcoming meetings?
I just have one. The other thing under new business, the 2017 Local Board of Appeal and Equalization date. That is set to be April 24th, 2017 at 6:00 p.m. And that will be noticed, I think that gets sent to property owners, but it's also noticed throughout the city. So we have those notifications up. I just wanted to announce it formally at a meeting as well. With regards to upcoming meetings, the Planning and Zoning Commission meeting has been canceled or will be canceled on Wednesday due to lack of an agenda. Otherwise, I don't have anything.
Acknowledgements.
I'd like to acknowledge Joanne Faust for her years of service. I know this is her last day, official day with us, but just working with her over the time I've been here, which has been a little over a year, she's been a great asset to staff and has done a lot of work with us, and it's been hard transitioning without her, and I've learned a lot from her and just want to thank her for everything she's done.
Pardon me, it looks like I may have missed it, but did any of you, regarding this new employee, did any of you on your own or all do any research at all, any Googling, anything?
Mm-hmm. I did.
Well, I did too, and if it's the same person, there's, I don't know, picked up from Hawkins, I guess.
Any other acknowledgements? I have a couple. I would like to acknowledge the fire department, the Red Cross, White County Community Action, and everybody that helped with the fire at Rose Haven. Joanne, for her years with us.
I have more of a reminder. Montrose Day Celebration has a fish fry going on here Friday starting at 4:30. And then later in the month here, the 26th, the luau starting at 5. 24th, excuse me. Didn't have the date on top of my head, sorry. And then again, I'd like to thank Joe also. It was a pleasure working with you. Gained very good knowledge going, accompanying you to businesses here in town when I was able to work with you on the EDA. It was a great pleasure, and I want to wish you the best of luck.
Kevin, did you have anything before we adjourn? No? Motion to adjourn?
Second.
All in favor?